the deer panted for the water, so my soul longs after you. You are my heart's desire, and I long to worship you. You alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my speed. You alone are my heart, desire, and I long to worship you. You alone, you are my friend, you are my brother. Even though you are a king, you said, I will come, I'm coming. Oh, I'm waiting you. My Lord Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ, Lamb of God, you're coming soon. Hallelujah. Pray the Lord, give me. Lamb of God, pray the Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Lift a hand. Be prayed. Be Lord God with us always. Amen, amen. Maranatha, thank you, Lord. I want to continually preaching the part two, nuclear Armageddon is at the door. Part two. I want you to listen. Today's message, it is important that the North Korea crisis is boiling, you know. And this nation makes rapid advance in its nuclear weapon and missile program. Its leader, bad guy, Kim Jong-un, crazy guy, also making increasingly frequent manners and brilliant activity specific threat to use those weapon they are making, missile, bomb, against the United States and other target, other nation. We are watching now. I want to tell you, today's key message concerning about this word, Matthew 24, chapter 21 through the 22, as I had preaching last week. This passage, Christ speaks of an event to occur that does signal the end of the this world and of age of man, humankind. And it shows that his return is at the door. Yes, that's what I want to tell you. Let me tell you, at that time, the Christ spoke these alarming words regarding the end of this age. Jesus Christ prophesied at the Mount Olive to the disciples. A global war that could threaten to kill every living person, listen, was not yet technically possible. It was not possible when Jesus Christ had spoken about this topic, regarding and the sign of this age, what's going on. Verse 24, 21 to 22. It was impossible to annihilate all human beings by some weapon that was made by human beings at that time. Today, we continue to hold each other on nuclear gunpoint, which we are seeing now. This fact, I want to understand. This is a fact that we are seeing now, that nuclear weapon North Korea is making and threatened in this country and other country is real. It's not fantasy. It's a novel story. This is real. We are seeing every day. Jesus Christ said the prophesied that I am talking to you now. This fact helps us to see that many key Bible prophecies about World War III, which is Armageddon, last war of humankind. And it will not be possible at the 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ prophesied when disciples asked, what will happen at the end of the world? Jesus Christ respond of that question. He said, of this world. I say again, World War III only be possible in the modern nuclear age where we are living now. Yeah, it is possible. It could be happen at this modern, this age. This shows that of time of unprecedented, you know, destruction prophesied in Matthew 24, 21, 22 refers to what we would now call World War III, which is Armageddon. One third of your Bible is a prophecy that is going to tell about the future time, what's going on in this world. Through the Old Testament, the New Testament, such like Ezekiel 38, 39 chapter, Zechariah 14 chapter, some Psalms, yes, Psalm 81, it, of course, Revelation, Book of Revelation, that are talking about all things of the future times that is going to happen. I want to say, yet traditional Christian, traditional Christian, you know what I'm talking about, virtually ignore of these prophecies that are mentioned in the Bible. That is what the fourth seal in Revelation chapter 6, Jesus Christ opened the fourth seal. That religious deception was revealed. And being revealed, it's going on, revealed until Jesus Christ will come. Many false prophet came out and is now will come again. So what I'm saying, many Christians, I would say, actually doesn't believe this prophecy that going to tell the future by Jesus Christ and the other prophet like Apostle John. That is what the forced seal is all about. Religious deception. We can now exterminate all human life by this nuclear weapon. Jesus Christ already had prophesied. No flesh would be survived unless Jesus Christ intervened and to stop this event. That's 24, chapter 21, verse 22. Yes. That is the great ultimate advancement of the man are going to make. The killing, the people, each other. Doesn't that prove there is something terribly wrong with man? Yet, is still on return to God. People of the world who don't believe and in doing the evil things, like North Korea bad man, by evil people who are going to killing other people, the Christians. They don't care what God is talking about. No, they don't know Bible, but they don't know word of God. They are still on to return to God. That's why they are doing what they want to do, to killing the people by the making mess, destruction, the weapon. They're going to kill them in the mess the people at one time. Atomic bomb, missile bomb. Why aren't the world Christian more concerned about this today? So my question is, why don't they Christian about concerned about this problem in today? Why don't they think about and do not concede of this the sign of end of the world that Jesus Christ prophesied? It's a time to think about. And we are seeing now what's going on by North Korea and Iran and the evil country. Jesus Christ was a true Christian like you and me who follow the word of God. We are listening, that you are listening. What Christ is talking to the sign of this day, that you should think of the word that I had talking to, the sign of the end of the world. Because you should watch and pray for the nation. Of course, yourself too. You will be protected. The Jesus Christ promised. You can see that. I'm telling you again and again. This prophecy you've heard is obviously, I'm sure, obviously nuclear warfare that is going to happen. Yes. This is not my idea. Jesus Christ told in this Bible. Verse 24, chapter 21 through 22. Read again and again. But some people say, so what? What led to me? This word Jesus Christ told them. I don't care what's going on. I want to say today, will they have to experience those events before they say more that also what? Too late. Yeah. We surely ought to listen Christ what he said. No one word of his will fail. The Bible says, even though everything has changed, not my world change. My world will be forever. I say again, Matthew chapter 24, chapter 21 to 22 are talking about the nuclear war. So devastating that, as Jesus Christ said, no flesh would survive. If Christ didn't intervene and stop it, nobody will survive. He said. Would you say we are close to that time? Let me tell you, intelligence agency like CIA and defense experts, I've heard many times this time, I know you've heard many times this time through the TV, say North Korea could now have the power to destroy major cities in America and whole world knows that Iran, crazy country, Muslim country, Iran could become a nuclear power extremely soon. They have now. They are making nuclear bomb to attack Israel. That is their goal, to destroy Israel. Israel. We have to pray for the Jerusalem. Yes, the Bible says, pray for Jerusalem. You will be peace. You feel the peace. Oh, hallelujah. The iron, the, you know, leader said, America is a big Satan. Israel is a small Satan. They used to say Israel should be cleared on this map, should be annihilated on this planet. They cursed Israel. Ida, evil empire. Listen, my brother and sister. These two men, who, North Korea leader and Iran leader, the madman, crazy guy, could be ready, listen careful, to attack America with a nuclear weapon. Yeah, I just say this CIA and defense expert said, yeah, that is true. Oh my, you know, I'm not talking about no more this like concerning with nations news. I want to go back to Bible. That's why I want to focus, and it's what I'm going to say today's message concerning with nuclear weapon. Our holy hope is to repent spiritually. If nation refuse to repent, individuals, you, me, each other, can repent and pray every day to God's help that this nation should be protected by your guidance, and our enemy will be defeated by the power of God. We have to pray every day. Then you will be protected by the angel of the Lord, hallelujah, at these dangerous times where we are living now. I believe. So today's text, I want to say it. Revelation 1 chapter 6. If we pray continually day by day, this is promised by the Lord. Apostle John had received the revelation. Listen, I want to read today's text, Revelation 1 chapter 5, 6. to him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood. Hallelujah. And has made us to be, this is a big word, a kingdom and a priest, your priest, to serve his God, our Lord, our Master, our King is coming soon. Because Jesus said, look at this world, what's going on? It's a time. It's a time. Is near at the right. To serve his God and Father, to him be glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Praise, give the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. And the power forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, be glory. Hallelujah. All this nuclear insanity by the two crazy guy, leader of North Korea and Ida, who are the king of evil, should be destroyed by the power of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Give me glory. They are going to kill many, many people. Of course, Christian. All, I say again, all this nuclear crazy activity by two men in two countries is also part of the sign, part of the sign of the second coming and the sign of the end of the age when Christ will save humanity from totally exterminating itself. Are you listening? The real nuclear damage is not inflicted by these two madmen. This is my conclusion of this sermon. You should know. This is Jesus Christ said, the Bible said by the many, many prophets, that the real end of the world that is coming. And the sign we can see that Jesus Christ is at the hand, at the door. I believe you've heard many times through the Bible, abomination of desolation. Abomination of desolation. Christ described in Matthew 24, chapter 15, this abomination will be the major force that endangers the life of the every person on this earth, but it will be too late to the march when you actually understand what Daniel and the other prophet taught about the events that lead up to the abomination that makes desolate with its nuclear bomb. So, what do we have to do? Step by step, we can trace all the prophecies the Bible described, and the event that points to that sign until Christ returns. You know what I'm saying? This is my point to, you should know. At this time, those Korea events that they're going to threaten every nation, including the South Korea and this country, is not real sign of this end age that Jesus Christ had prophesied at the Mount Olive. It because Pyongyang, the capital of North Korea, is not talking about Jesus Christ had prophesied. Jerusalem, the capital, the city of the God, Jerusalem will be the last fire point where all the nations come attack the Israel to destroy the people of Israel by Antichrist with a nuclear bomb. I believe Iran and other Muslim countries participated, and the other countries will be joined together. A free-aged army attacked the Jerusalem. That will be the sign that Jesus Christ had prophesied the end of the world. So, let me tell you, although we don't know the day of the hour when Jesus will come, second coming, but we know this is at the door. Jesus Christ has told us. So we have to pray and watch with our fist to eagerly desire to waiting to see the Jesus Christ they will come in. That Jesus Christ asked us in this time. Hallelujah. Amen. That you will be keep the peace and joyful in your mind when you pray in this title of your prayer, Jesus Christ asked. Hallelujah, pray the Lord. Because Jesus Christ said, promised, I will be shortened of this time. You will not be going through this tribulation. We are going up to see Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, praise the Lord. Bye-bye.